Now, one of our inspirational stories, though, that we covered a month ago gave a huge amount of interest on our Facebook page. So we decided to do a follow-up. Please welcome back to the cafe the Kindness Institutes, Kristina Cavit, and one of her talented rangatahi students, AJ Tuipea, who's been through the program.
Welcome guys.
Hello, guys.
Yeah.
Good to have you back. AJ, welcome to the show. Okay, Kristina, how has this response been since last time you were on here?
It's been pretty amazing. I've had people who I bump into on the street saying, saw your video, it was so cool, and had a ton of shares, and we got some really generous donations.
Oh, that is great. Yeah. So for those who perhaps missed it last time, tell us, give a quick rundown of what the Kindness Institute's all about.
Sure, so it's a charity I set up to support New Zealanders from all walks of life to manage stress and deal with challenges that come their way. So we do that through yoga and meditation, and we support wonderful young people like AJ and other youth. We work in mainstream school with kids who've been kicked out of school and with women in prison as well.
And AJ, how did you find out about the Kindness Institute? How did you end up there?
Oh, well, I got told about it from my English teacher, and he chose me as well as three other boys from school to attend the Kindness Institute program, so yeah, it was good.
And really? What did you like about it when you went there?
I just like meeting new people, new experiences for me.
So when you go along to it, what was your first impressions? Did it all seem a little bit weird? Because this obviously not something you'd come across before, mindfulness and meditation?
Yeah, before attending it, I got told about doing yoga and meditation, and I thought to myself, wow, that's like way out of my comfort zone. Not me at all. But the more we did it, because she took us to yoga meditation every morning, and the more we did it together, the more confident and comfortable I felt with doing yoga, so yeah, it was good.
And what do you personally get out of it? Because I would imagine your confidence grows at the same time. But, you know, when you go to one of the classes, what is it that you walk away with?
Self-confidence, really.
Yeah.
Yeah, I learned heaps of stuff from the, like, life lessons and self-control and self-confidence. So, yeah, that's something wrong for me, self-confidence.
So you're in year 11 at school. Has it helped you with your sort of schooling, with your focus?
Yeah, really, I've been stressing a lot over schoolwork and level one.
Yeah, you're not alone there.
Yeah, so yeah, it was good.
And I heard a rumour that you are now, you know, quite involved with the Kindness Institute.
Yeah.
What are you doing there now? You're taking classes, I hear?
You've been teaching the
others. Yeah, I've been teaching the other students about what she told me, yoga and meditation.
So, nice.
So, Kristina, is this the kind of response that you hoped to get? I mean, this is like AJ your star pupil, so to speak?
He's definitely a golden boy. No, his response has been more than I could have ever hoped for. And I think the most important thing with our kaupapa is that the young people go away feeling valued, feeling that they're loved, and I hope that's what you've felt in our program.
Definitely.
And did I hear you got a letter as well from someone who practically you changed their life?
Yeah, she forwarded an email to me about some messaging them that I've changed their life while emceeing the Artify Showcase.
And okay, hang on, slow down. So you were a little bit shy, and then all of a sudden you're emceeing some of the showcases. No way.
It was, I don't know.
Is it the first time you've been in that sort of, you know, in front of that many people before?
Really, yeah.
And it's the change of life, so how did that make you feel?
I felt proud of myself. I never knew I would do something for someone like
that. And you're teaching your family now too, the skills of meditation. And what was their reaction?
Their reaction was like mine when I first heard about yoga and meditation. They felt like it was out of their comfort zone as well, but the more we did it together, it was good.
And that's a really interesting question, because I wanted to know, how do you convince other young people to get involved when, I guess, people hear the word yoga and meditation, they don't associate it with youth? Yeah. Has that been hard for you to get them involved?
Yeah, it's hard for anyone, but if you commit to it, it lays off leaves.
I don't think it's necessarily that they don't put it together with youth. It's probably more that they don't put it together with young men, really. Mm. Young men who are at school doing NCA level one.
Yeah.
And what do you hope to do in the future?
Well, I hope to become an actor.
Nice.
Yay. Nice.
So, yeah.
Okay, so we can keep this and we can put it back. And you know when they're doing those things in Hollywood, like before they were famous? We can play this one and go, yeah, we knew him. We knew him. We always knew it was going to be a big deal.
And Kristina, you must be immensely proud. What's next for the Kindness Institute?
Yeah, so proud, so grateful to have met AJ and all the other rangatahi. Our next step is to keep working with these beautiful young people, keep building up their leadership capabilities, and to expand our program with the young women in prison. Norman, and we're also going to be working with teachers and educators to kind of professionally develop them to use these tools as well.
Brilliant wow. work, yeah, thank
you. That's fantastic.
You.
It's been great having you in.
Yeah, good work, AJ. Thanks so much, Kristina and AJ. And if you want to find out more, you can head to thekindnessinstitute.com and do some donations.